What's going on, everybody? JaymesHanson back again to bring you the Bleach spoilers of episode 35, I believe. Anyway, and we've got a lot to talk about, but I want to apologize for also being late because I've been sick. But for consistency, even though the episode's tomorrow, we're going to talk about my expectations going into this. Anyway, so if you like these videos, hit that like, that subscribe, and let's get into it, shall we? Now, of course, there's already been a lot of talk and discussion about this episode as a whole, so I'm just going to give a brief talk about the synopsis and pictures, as always, and then give my thoughts. So, let's get into the synopsis, shall we? Of course, Google translation, bad translation, it's definitely messed up on Mayuri's Bankai, but I'm just going to read it as it is anyway, just to give you the gist of what we're going to be talking about within this spoiler video. Kuritsuchi Mayuri swallows Penida with his modified Bankai. Golden Hikizaku Jiso demon, whatever that is, right? Symptoms, and laughs loudly in the fourth Bleach district. However, something strange happens to Mayuri's Bankai, we'll just call it. Meanwhile, Urahara Kisuke and Kyoraku Shunsui sense a fluctuation in Mayuri's spiritual pressure, and despite Mayuri's worries, they worry about the situation of the Shinigami, whose number has decreased, or have decreased, to the point that they can sense places from far away, so Kyoraku decides to take on Rije, or Riribaro, himself. So let's take a brief glance at the images. Of course, you've probably all seen this one, Kyoraku with his sword out, facing Riribaro. Nothing too exciting here, except for just some clean artwork, which is always appreciated. And of course, it really must be really annoying to draw Kyoraku with all those lines and, you know, beard hair. And definitely, I don't think it's drawn. I think it's just like a texture layering of effects for his kimono. But again, yeah, Kyoraku Shunsui right there. Riribaro right there. Them two facing off or coming to terms with each other. Also with an image of Nanao, which again isn't anything too special, probably just looking at her commander-in-chief being Kyoraku. Then we have Ichigo, which seems like we're going to be getting more Ichigo versus Asuka Nakureva coming right up, and it seems that Ichigo might be struggling a little bit here. Interesting facial feature here, but of course I love a bit of hair animation. I'm a bit of a sucker for Ichigo hair animation. And then of course Asuka being the next image, holding his four gift balls towards, which I would assume would be either Ichigo or Grimmjow in this case. And that's pretty much it. And it's interesting because you just get some episode spoilers where you have something to talk about and some that there's nothing to talk about. In this case, it is just stare downs between characters and just a speculation towards, I guess, Ichigo and Asuka in this case, which of course I would always really prefer that they would extend that fight other than Ichigo being shown as a pancake in the manga. So if they can elaborate on that, perfect. Kubo, nice choice of direction. I think the biggest excitement for people throughout this episode is the fact that the staff listing, Taguchi's back, storyboarding, fantastic, and some people that worked on episode 6 as well. I don't really know too much about animators per se, or what their jobs or role or backgrounds are, but you know, when you know that there's good people on this episode, people tell you that it's good, and I recognize some names, and I recognize them from episode 6. Now, I'm not saying to get your expectations on an episode 6 level, because I just don't think it is the case. Though, from going from the poem from the last episode showing the Shunsui Bankai kind of effect on the floor, I don't know. Is it? I think we're gonna get maybe a. Do we? Yeah, I think we do. Because I've seen some things online. So I do think we get Kyoraku's Bankai in this episode. Because we're going to get to see, I've seen images that we get to see Kyoraku's manifested sword. I guess we're going to get Kyoraku's Bankai, which it's going to be interesting. I think, I don't know if it's going to, I don't want to hype myself up or you guys as the viewer, because every time we see a good staff listing, usually it's good for the majority of the pub, but everyone expects that episode 6, and I don't know why. Because for me, I preferred episode 7 over episode 6. And to be honest with you, a lot of you are going to disagree with me. How can I say this? I don't want to say episode 6 wasn't hype, because it absolutely was, right? And there was some madness in that episode. But I just think there's some episodes that just do it a little bit better. Not in every aspect, not a full episode. And I think the fact that Yamamoto versus Yuha was a full episode, I think that that's why there was such hype around it. Maybe, But I just don't think I think episode 6 has always just give people like that this is the episode, and I feel like people are going to try so much to find that replacement for episode 6, but I just don't think it's going to be replaced because the expectation is way too high for people to let it pass episode 6. And to be honest with you, if there was a thing that surpasses episode 6, if there was something that was going to surpass it, I would like it to be Ichigo's Horn of Salvation. I want it to be, you know, Naruto got Kurama mode or Baron mode, or you know, the Naruto versus Sasuke. You know, Naruto had that moment for Naruto, right? Luffy had that moment for Gear 5. Ichigo had that moment for Dongai. I'm not going to lie, he had it for Dongai. But that was over 10 years ago. We need a Horn of Salvation. Like, this is end of series stuff, right? So we need an end of series send-off, per se. So if anything, for me, for my expectation for an episode 6, I want it to be Horn of Salvation, right? That's what I want. So anytime I see, like, you know, episode 6 staff on an episode, I'm going to hold my expectations. If it's better, then cool. I think if it is Kiraku's Bankai this episode, which it seems to be, obviously, then I'm very excited to see if I understand it better. Because in the manga, like, you understood it, right? It was very poetic in its own sense, but I want more elaboration, more explanation, more deeper dive and effect into this. And, you know, a lot of the time, anime can kind of bring out a lot of explanation through visuals that we couldn't get in the manga before. So, and BBS did a great job at some of that too. So I'm very excited to see what it's like in this episode too. But I think the main topic about this spoilers thing is that we are going to get, obviously, as the anime has been doing since, you know, Core 2, it moves things around. And I think it's a good thing, and I've really thought about this a lot, and having, you know, Friend being completely skipped and having it towards the end of the core makes sense, because you want to build up Basby and you want to build up these little inklings to build up to that big potential finale. I have an idea of how it's going to end, but I kind of want to wait to see how it's going to go. Obviously, we know that next week after this episode, it's going to be Mayuri and Baby Hold Your Hand again. And then after that, we're probably going to go into Nanao, and then we're going to get into probably Friend-ish type of stuff. Bear in mind, we have got, like, flashbacks with, obviously, Nemu. Mayuri got flashbacks with Nanao. We got flashbacks with Kyoraku, so there's a lot of things to adapt in such a short amount of time. And, you know, there's obviously discussions about this being potentially a 14-episode core, you know, but I'm treating it as a 13-episode because I don't know. I don't look into leaks anymore. So I think the rearranging is good. It's giving off the vibe that these things are happening at the same time or very close to each other. Hence why we got the, you know, the Uryu versus Renji at the start of Baby Hold Your Hand. And then, of course, you're going to have the Kyoraku stuff happening simultaneously. And then while Kyoraku's having his fight with Lile Barrow, obviously the Mayuri fight is still going. So we're going to go back and forth. And it gives that sense of, like, things all happening all at once. And if Kyoraku does do the whole Bankai thing, obviously I would like it to kind of be shown a little bit within Baby Hold Your Hand if they're trying to go for a simultaneous route. You know, when he uses his Bankai and all the Reishi, everyone kind of reacts like, oh, what's this? You know, what's this deep, you know, spiritual energy? I hope that kind of shows or hints itself within Baby Hold Your Hand too, in terms of, like, a radius, unless Mayuri's just that far away from that battleground that he doesn't get to. But if they sense Mayuri's reaction, then surely Mayuri would be able to sense Kyoraku's. Anyway, I'm waffling. I'm really late with this. I'm sorry. I'm not of the best of health right now, so a bit of a quick one for you guys. But tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comment section down below of what you guys think. With that being said, I'm going to catch my folks later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Jaymes Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.